Hello all. Today we are going to discuss regarding how will you manage a patient with anaphylaxis when he coming to the emergency room. Right now I have received a call from my EMT staff that a patient with a suspected anaphylaxis is going to come to the emergency department. So as you know, the most important thing when you manage any emergency that you should be prepared enough. So when you look into that, you make sure that all your equipments are being ready. You make sure that your crash cart is loaded. Your crash cart, everything is ready in the crash cart. Basically, you can just see the crash cart here. We have loaded all the drugs that is needed for a cardiac arrest or maybe an anaphylaxis management. Everything will be there. Can you just open it and show? So all the drugs are available here. So you are make sure that your first thing, the crash cart is ready, and all the airway management equipments, like starting from your ambu bag, you can see the ambu bag which is kept ready, and you can see the laryngeal mask airway, LMA. If you are unable to intubate a patient, you might need a laryngeal LMA, so that is being kept ready. Then you have the ET tube. You have different sizes of ET tube. As you know that ET tube size, for an adult male we need an 8 to 8.5 and adult female 8 to 7.5, so that is the size. And different sizes of laryngoscope, maybe video, if you have a video laryngoscope, that is good, but you have to keep everything ready. But since in this patient you are going to have an anaphylaxis, the next most important thing that you need to keep in your mind is that the patient might be having a difficult airway. That means you might not be able to intubate or ventilate the patient. Because of the glottic edema, you may not be able to intubate her, or maybe you not be able to ventilate her also. So in that circumstances, you need to always think that you need to prepare with your surgical airway. So surgical airway, as you know, there can be different types. There can be a needle cricothyrotomy, that is a jet ventilation, or a surgical cricothyrotomy, or maybe even a tracheostomy. So the most important thing in management of any emergency is the management of the airway. So the airway management is the key in a patient with anaphylaxis or whatever be that scenario. So we are make sure that all the things are kept ready. You can see the patient monitor is being ready. You can see that the defibrillator, which is again very important, that you need to see whether the patient is having, what is the type of rhythm the patient is having, whether the patient is having any cardiac bradycardia or any tachycardia. We need to see the cardiac monitor. So these are the basic things that you need to keep ready when the patient is coming to the emergency room. As in an Indian setup, we don't have the adrenaline auto injectors available. So hopefully they will not be taking an adrenaline outside the hospital. So you need to give them adrenaline when they come in. So now when the patient arrives, what are the basic bare minimum things that you need to keep in your mind? There are different algorithms for the management of anaphylaxis, but what I prefer you to learn maybe in the resuscitation council, European resuscitation council algorithm, which is very clearly mentioning what to do when a patient comes to you with anaphylaxis. I will show you at the end of my presentation. So basically the anaphylaxis algorithm, whatever it is, very simple. So a patient is having anaphylactic reaction. The first thing, as I told, is the airway, followed by breathing, circulation, disability, and exposure. So how will you diagnose an anaphylaxis? That is next key important point. It is usually an acute onset illness. The patient will be having a sudden onset of symptom. It will not be a gradual onset just like that. The patient will be having sudden onset of symptom. Maybe the patient was in a restaurant, he was having some seafood, suddenly he developed starting having itching and starting some choking sensation, so that he might rush the emergency room. So it always remember that it is an acute onset of illness and it can be a life threatening. As I told, major things will be problem with the airway breathing, later on with the circulation. As the disease progress, it will be more into favor of a circulation, and usually you will have skin changes. The classical skin changes, what you can see from head to toe, will be you can start your swollen lip, maybe redness of your eyes, maybe you can see hives, urticaria, all those things can be there. And sometimes the patient can even present with abdominal pain and vomiting. If it is a GI anaphylaxis, maybe an abdominal pain and vomiting. So that is the next thing that you need to keep in your mind. So as soon as the patient arrives, you need to assess the airway, breathing, and circulation. So you need to connect the patient to the monitor, put him on the saturation probe. You can see that BP cuff is available here. You can just open it. Okay. So you can connect to the BP cuff and the SpO2, which is again very important. That major thing, that problem will be arising from the airway. And always make sure that as an individual, it will be difficult for you to handle any emergency. So the next thing that you need to do is look into is the call for help. So here is Mr. Shino's EMT is available for my help. Maybe you need to have another person to help you, maybe to manage the airway, you need more help. So that will be the next thing. And make sure that the patient is lying flat. So that will be the next thing. Maybe a little bit propped up position, depending upon his comfort. good. Maybe the most important thing that you need to bear in mind is that you need to keep them flat, and maybe a 30 to 40 degree propped up position might help them to decrease the symptom. But again, there is a problem if the patient is having hypotension. If the patient is having hypotension, that means the cerebral perfusion is going to get affected. So it is better to lie them flat if the patient is having any compromise in the circulation. And if again, if the patient is having hypotension, maybe for initially you can just raise the leg. So these are just all first aid things. When the patient actually comes to the emergency room with an anaphylaxis, we need to go ahead and give the drug, which is the drug of choice. You can easily remember the drug of choice is adrenaline. But before that, as I told, these are the certain steps that you need to do. You have to confirm that it is a possible anaphylaxis by maybe a quick history we can do, and make sure that is airway, breathing, circulation is patent, and make sure that you establish an airway either using a face mask. You can start either with a non-rebreathing mask and start them on a high flow oxygen. Possible an IV line. If available, you can easily put an IV line as quickly as possible. Pulse oximeter. So these are the basic things that you need to remember. And the next most important thing, give me adrenaline. So next most important drug that you need to remember will be the adrenaline. So adrenaline is the drug of choice. No matter what, remember adrenaline. The problem is that many of the practitioners have fear in giving adrenaline because they might not know what is the dose. Oh, we use adrenaline in cardiac arrest. Why you want to use adrenaline in a minor anaphylaxis? But when you feel that it is an anaphylaxis and the patient is having an airway, breathing, circulation compromise, there should not be any hesitation in giving adrenaline, and you have to be very clear in its dosage. And adrenaline is 1 in 1000 dilution. You need to give 0.3 to 0.5 ml. You can remember that 0.5 ml IM or sub Q in an patient, in an adult patient with anaphylaxis. So that is the dose of adrenaline. I will repeat it again. Adrenaline 1 in 1000 dilution, 0.5 ml as an IM or a sub Q. That is the preferred drug of choice for the management of anaphylaxis. So that is the initial thing. Then you have the other options like chlorpheniramine maleate and hydrocortisone. The next the question arises is that what is the role of chlorpheniramine maleate and hydrocortisone? There are multiple studies where it has shown that there is no much benefit with these drugs, but there are certain benefit also. Maybe the patient itself will feel the allergic reaction, everything will coming down, the patient rashes, everything will come down when you give chlorpheniramine maleate and hydrocortisone, and the patient will clinically feel better. So the next important thing is that if the first drug we have given is adrenaline, the next thing, as I told, you need to have an IV access. Now coming to the IV access, you should have a large bore IV access kept ready. Ideally an 18 gauge, less than 18 gauge, 18 or 16 will be ideal. Minimum 2 large bore IV access, you can keep it ready. And you need to give IV fluids. The preferred IV fluid agent will be a crystalloid. Again, normal saline or lignin lactate will be the preferred agent. So you can give 20 ml per kg fluid boluses of any of these drugs. So that will be the next thing. So we have managed the anaphylaxis, we have given the adrenaline, we have given the next option, that is the circulation management, is by starting your IV fluid. Now, what are the signs that we'll say that, okay, this patient is having a life-threatening anaphylaxis. So life-threatening anaphylaxis in airway, you can have swelling, hoarseness, and stridor. As I told, I am just reading out the European Resuscitation Council guidelines, which I will share it with you. And breathing, it can be rapid breathing, wheeze, fatigue, and cyanosis, SpO2 less than 92% or confusion. Circulation, it can be pale, clammy, low blood pressure, faintness, drowsy, and coma. So once we have identified that the patient is in any of these comorbidities, any of these conditions, we have started them on the management of the airway, management of the breathing, management of circulation by giving adequate IV fluids. And the drug of choice I need you to remember is the adrenaline. And again, the most important thing, once you have stabilized the patient, the next most important thing that you need to remember is why this patient developed this anaphylaxis. As you know, it can be of multiple agents. It can be starting from your routine food products, maybe any cosmetics, any drugs. These are any number of things. So you have to go back and take a detailed history and why this patient developed, what was the precipitating factor for this anaphylaxis. So that is the next question that you need to answer. So once you answer that, then you have to identify that is the allergen and you have to remove it. So removing the allergen is the next thing. So we have done, you have find out that the patient is having, confirmed that the patient is having anaphylaxis. You have managed this airway, breathing, circulation. So maybe starting with an oxygen mask, maybe go ahead with the intubation or maybe a surgical airway. And coming to the circulation, we have given him adrenaline, then going with an IV fluid, 2 large bore IV access, you need to start, and you have to give a fluid boluses of around 20 ml per kg of crystalloid. That will be the drug of choice. So now we have come to the conclusion. Now the question arises, whom should I admit? So can I send him home? That is the next question. Or the patient need to stay back in the emergency room, or he need to get admitted to the emergency room. And the question is very, answer is pretty simple. If the patient's symptoms improve after 4 hours, the patient initial after 4 hours, the patient has dramatically improved and he don't have any other symptoms and he doesn't require any more further doses of adrenaline, definitely yes, he can go home. But if the patient is having any comorbidities or you need to have an intervention in between, that like that there was a gross airway compromise, there was a gross problem in the circulation, the patient need to stay back, or any other comorbid illness like any other cardiovascular risk or bronchial asthma, any other risk factor is there, it is better to keep them admitted inside the hospital. Or if the patient required multiple doses of adrenaline, you need to give twice or thrice doses of adrenaline, again those group of patients need to stay back. So let me one more thing to add on adrenaline. Again, there are a lot of practices, there are other practices like giving an IV adrenaline. So in certain times we need to continue them on an IV adrenaline also. So for example, the patient, we are given IM or sub-Q. As you know, in hypotension, the perfusion will be low to the tissue, so the absorption may be decreased. So in that point of time, you might need to give IV adrenaline. But for the sake of this discussion, I am not telling everyone to give IV adrenaline. But whenever you want to give IV adrenaline, it is better that you call your senior and get their opinion from them. Then you start on IV adrenaline. The dosage is pretty simple. You need to dilute it further, 1 in 10,000. And you need to take 1 ml from that. And you need to give it as a slow IV. There are different protocols available. But remember to give your 0.5 mg of adrenaline IM or sub-Q whenever you have a patient with anaphylaxis. So this is the algorithm that I will be sharing with you. Thank you.